But that should be interesting to the Indian people. We are not against the car, big buildings and sophistication of the rich. What we want is shelter, food and clothing for these people. We don't want honor for the poor, but we want at least them to be free from the horror of suffering and poverty. So this is what we call real economic value. We should be addressed. Instead of addressing banks, corporate sectors, understanding and also addressing poverty, malnutrition, unemployment, and assuring the methodology of each two players survival to the bottom level of the people in the society. That is a real thing. Fourth thing, I want to say something about the farmers. Naturally, I want to say farmers' friend. According to my knowledge, snake is already mentioned in the books as farmers' friend, as snake consumes everything that is against the farmers' cultivation. No particular party can be the farmers' friend at all. Because farmers, as it is an agrarian society, majority of the society is farmers. So in order to make a work encashment for the political brains, for their self-establishment, enrichment, re-torment, enthronement and pre-torment facilities, these methodologies are announced and activated in the society. Why I am saying this is very simple. Farmers should be given various opportunities to flourish, to improve their standard of their cultivation, to improve the methodologies of cultivation and marketing, and to enrich themselves. Without enriching farmers, making farmers eternally dependent on them by means of incentive, various other loan settlements, and more than survival compensations and boosting. Suicidal compensations are more, which make the person to feel death more preferable than survival. Is it the methodology of boosting the society? Not at all. So what we want to say is, farmers should be given the methodologies of technical facilities, various other information facilities, various other integral federal quality facilities for more cultivation productivity, without which they are made more lazy and their ability is still. And after few years of this old settlement, etc., even their recall for agriculture they could not do because the minds are washed away from the technicalities of proper way of agronomy. That is the real status. So what we want to do is, already we have made a project to China also, and that has not been implemented and submitted also. It is multiple agriculture, mass cultivation, mechanical cultivation, mainstream cultivation, and insurance facilities in agriculture for promoting real agriculture. If it's a small people doing in fragments, even traditional lands after two or three generations, they are just scissored into pieces. How it can be properly viable and economically feasible? So that should be mass cultivation, mixed farming, and cultivation through mechanization by means of tractor or satellite facilities for composite cultivation of thousands of hectares, where humidity rate, morbidity rate, pesticide rate, irrigation rate, and soil structure rate, and erosion rate, everything can be interpreted, everything can be indicated, that is known as mechanical layer of agriculture, and insurance facilities, they should be mobilized. And whenever agriculture came, everybody went to agriculture, then industrial boundary, revolution came, everybody from agriculture was shifted to foundries, agriculture was quiet. IT industry came, everybody from foundries, they shifted to IT, the foundries are quiet. So, that should be the proper way of professional, demographic, equitability, equity and distribution, by which we have to analyze what is the productivity of the nation and what are the industrial rate of growth and what is the academic strength that is coming out of their education, how they can be employed, how they can be counseled and trained for their specific purposes so that all sectors can have multiple growth. This thing has not been scientifically dealt at all and also successfully it has not been implemented. It should be the medulla oblongata, that is the backbone of economic civilization, and each and every conference should mainframe only this thing, how to create multi-sector growth in the society by means of quantitative and qualitative training using the academic and professional demography. It is a very, very interesting subject to talk. Should be done. Then coming to recession, I have already told, recession is like pimple. It is just like pimple and boils in the body, and if it is made cancerous, if it is made capricious, if it is made intensive due to negligence and due to immunity loss, then there is a problem of the society. So recession is very common. And coming to recession, I want to submit one small point. Recession cannot come in one fresh dawn like lightning, thunder or tsunami or something else. Even tsunami, thunder, lightning, they have a lot of subtlety processes which are not visible to a naked eye or even instrument condition. So before this recession, pre-recession, pseudo-recession, subtle recession, sub-recession, all of these various portions are there. Before the recession comes, there will be small disturbances in various clusters of the society, that is pre-recession. Sub-recession is of intensive problems, small very 2 millimeters problem will occur and dust may grow into something that is known as pseudo, that appears to be growing, that may grow or may not. So when you are having the level of sub-recession, subtle recession, pseudo recession, and various other, even infra recession in there, all of these areas, even we can identify before 1 or 2 years. Great people like Lavrovini and Alan Greenspan, they have given a lot of things. Even Montreal, there is an international research institute on economic research and development economics, where they have given a book even before 3 years, US net recession. The way of life that US people, they are living beyond their means and their expenditure as well as their credit fantasy, that is going to lead them to the pathway of recession. So already the prediction has been made by people. So at the time of these levels, these predominant levels of recession, we have to identify and remove that. And there are 4 zones of recession. The first zone or the first quarter, we understand is indication. First we can understand is indication and expansion. The second zone we are understanding is intensification and getting vigilance. We are becoming alert. The third thing is reform and revival zone. And the fourth zone is growth and stability. So it enters by indication, then it permeates, then it intensifies, creating or provoking vigilance inside. We get into reforms and we revive the economy, we grow by ourselves and stabilize. This is the nature for all the economy. This zone classification is to be made. And each and every periodical study of the zone should be exclusively maintained for understanding the rate of growth and rate of our involvement and participation in the subject. So that is the second thing. Somebody told that recession and depression are different ways. Recession is just neighbor being jobless and depression is you being jobless. It is a relative term. It means that, for example, for the neighbor, your recession may be his depression and depression may be recession. So it becomes relative. And moreover, our being jobless, that becomes self-concern and somebody else, that becomes lack of some sort of sociocentric nature. So it is not like that. What is depression and what is recession? That is a very minute classification and secret. If you become jobless, it is recession. If all of your professional and living neighborhood, they are all jobless, that is known as depression. Number one. Number two, if misfortune commits you, that is recession. If you become misfortune and circle, that is known as depression. If it is transient, that is recession. If it is prolongated and permanent and cyclic, that becomes depression. If you write to the king for your concern or favor, that is known as recession. If the king receives you for your favor, that is depression. So these things are the various status within the whole national economy is subjected to turmoil or futuristic turmoil or impending or imminent turmoil. That is in depression and this is in recession. I have already talked about the economic pathology in which there are diagnostic factors as well as pharmacogenomic factors. What are the diagnostic tools for understanding this recession? Just as we are having a lot of symptom studies in pathology, certainly it should be there in the case of recession also. What are they? Number one, stock value is the first and foremost indication for this type of recessions. But there are 3 types of stock value studies. One is indicative stock market. Second is responsive or consequential stock market. Third thing is innocuous stock market, where the stock market falls and where it can indicate a future recession, it is known as indicative. Where recession comes and brings a stock market.